What are the Georgia Guidestones? What if I told you that America has its own Stonehenge? That's right. These giant stones were set up on a hillside at, of all places, Atlanta, Georgia, in 1980. The man who built them remains anonymous, as does the monument's true purpose. In fact, other than their $500,000 price tag, almost nothing is known about the stones at all. They're composed of 119 tons of solid granite and have coded messages that are engraved into them in the world's 8 most commonly spoken languages. These rectangular pillars are precisely crafted to track astrological and solar cycles. There are some who interpret the messages here as a signal of the end of days, of the end of the world. Others theorize that they're a call for genocide on a massive scale. So what is the message they contain? Who built them? And why are they located on a remote hillside in Georgia? And what are they intended to guide us toward? Well, how and why the Guidestones were built have never been answered. But here's what we do know. The monument didn't just appear out of nowhere. This was no small project. It was a massive project. And the monument stands 19 foot and 3 inches at its tallest point. The height of the 4 basic stones is 16 foot 4 inches. The weight of this monument is 237,000 pounds, more than 118 tons. The capstone dimensions are 9 foot 8 inches long, 6 foot 6 inches wide, 1 foot 7 inches thick. So the total volume of granite used was 951 cubic foot. And the total cost was $500,000. As you can see, this is no simple pile of rocks. Now, on a summer day in 1979, a man using the alias R.C. Christian shows up at the Elberton Granite Finishing Company. He presents very detailed and specific plans, and he tells them that he wants to build the Georgia Guidestones. Now, the only details we have about this man is that he was balding, with a fringe of white hair, and he had an accent, suggesting he was from the Plain States. Also, he had money, lots and lots of money. The only thing he demanded was that he remain absolutely anonymous. To this very day, no one has been able to figure out who he is. What this man Christian commissioned, though, was no small undertaking. The Georgia Guidestones are more than just granite slabs. Much, much more. Some say it's mysterious. Others say it's downright sinister. The Guidestones were unveiled during a public ceremony in 1980. They were immediately controversial. Supporters like Yoko Ono praised their message as a stirring call to rational thinking. But opponents attacked them, calling them the Ten Commandments of the Antichrist. So what are the messages on these stones? First, you need to know that each message appears in English, Spanish, Swahili, Hindi, Hebrew, Arabic, Chinese, and Russian, the 8 most widely commonly spoken languages on earth, which means that the 10 lines on each slab are intended for all of the world's inhabitants to see. But as for the message themselves, the first 9, reading from the bottom up, seem to be a benign call, very benign call, to higher thinking. And this is what it reads. It says, "Don't be a cancer on the earth. Seek harmony. Balance personal rights with social duties. Avoid petty laws. Rule with reason. Unite humanity with a new language and guide reproduction wisely." But you see, it's the topmost directive on these stones that stops everyone cold in their tracks and sends a chill down your back. This is what it reads. It says, "Maintain humanity under 500 million people in perpetual balance with nature." Well, let's read that again. "Maintain humanity under 500 million people in perpetual balance with nature." A human population under 500 million would mean that more than 6.5 billion people would have to die or be killed. That's exactly right. The directive on the stones makes some believe that the Guidestones are calling for the mass murder of billions of innocent people, a global genocide that would kill the vast majority of the human race. So which interpretation is accurate? Or is there another interpretation altogether? The only way to find out is to decode who or what is behind the creation of the Guidestones themselves. Now, in addition to the messages written on the Guidestones, they are oriented to the stars. You see the east and west corners of the monument track sunrise and sunset. Also, a slot in one of the slabs marks the winter and summer solstice. A shaft drilled through the center central stone marks Polaris, the North Star. And a slit cut through the capstone marks the perfect moon. That means these Guidestones have a calendar, a compass, a translator, and a guide. It's like a granite Swiss Army knife. So why are these Guidestones in the state of Georgia, only miles from the city of Atlanta, in Elberton? Turns out there's a serious and mysterious reason for that. You see, the theory of Earth changes was first propounded by a mystic named Edgar Cayce. Early in the 20th century, Cayce argues that we are rapidly approaching a time of devastating changes to the surface of the Earth. Now, those changes could be the result of an earthquake, asteroid, or a comet impact, volcanoes, or solar flares, or whatever. As we've seen, particularly in terms of the 2012 believers, but also as with previous apocalypse believers, such as those who fear the end of the world would accompany the new millennium, or those who saw global devastation coming as Halley's Comet returned, or any of the hundreds of other doomsday faiths that have come and gone. The specific details of the actual apocalypse vary from believer to believer, and some of them had already been proven inaccurate. Now, for the purpose of the decoding of the Guidestones is the consequences of devastation. And those consequences include a radically altered surface of the Earth, a surface that will be without many of the most familiar features of the world that we know. Well, what sort of features? Just minor things like the state of California or New York City or parts of Florida and other land masses throughout the world. That's kind of scary. No, that's very scary. But according to Cayce's Earth Changes theory, it turns out that in addition to the changes that would alter the physical face of the world, there are safe zones that would ride out the Earth changes, and in doing so, provide a psychic focus for the energies needed to rebuild the world. And where are those safe zones? You guessed it. One of them is in rural Georgia. It's where the Guidestones stand, meaning they're ready to help the survivors of the Earth rebuild a new world and rebuild it better than before. That's right. The Georgia Guidestones are located in a zone that's safe from devastating changes to the Earth's surface, like floods, earthquakes, asteroids, volcanoes, solar flares, disasters that some believe would bring an end to modern civilization as we know it. Now, personally, I believe that the Georgia Guidestones are, on one level, exactly what they appear to be, a tool for getting people to think about the nature of existence and the ways in which that existence could be improved. I think there's a good chance that the person behind the Guidestones are a Rosicrucian. That's right, a Rosicrucian. I know, you may not know what that word Rosicrucian means. I'll tell you what that is in the next video. But I also think there's a motivation for the stones that may have been overlooked, and that the motivation lies in the times of during which they were commissioned and created. The Georgia Guidestones come into being in the late 1970s and early 1980s, and that was a time of enormous international tension between the United States and then still existing Soviet Union. And at the heart of those tensions, tens of thousands of nuclear warheads, an arsenal of destruction aimed at each other's throat, and more than capable of bringing civilization down in a mass of radioactive rubble. They are among one of the scariest times in human history and a reminder that we don't need an apocalypse beyond our control to end this world. For more than half a century, we've held the power to do it ourselves. self-inflicted genocide by nuclear bombs controlled by our governments and controlled by hate, the hate of others, the hate of others that are different from ourselves and people who believe different from us. And I think it was that reality of such a possibility that prompted this man, R.C. Christian, to create the message he placed on the Georgia Guidestones. A message intended for the survivors of a global nuclear war, a global nuclear holocaust. I believe it's a message designed to help restore balance on this earth and end the perpetual hate of each other and to avoid the mistakes that destroyed our ancestors. But that's what I think. Of course, there's only one person who really knows the real intent of the Georgia Guidestones. And that man is named R.C. Christian. But he's not talking. I hope one day he does come forth. But until then, we have the Georgia Guidestones themselves. Those Georgia Guidestones are speaking their message to the ages, each in its own way. So next time you're in the state of Georgia, go visit the Georgia Guidestones and get your own interpretation of the messages on these stones. Well, like, subscribe. Think for yourself. Question everything. This is a Mirrorlogic channel.